There's a reason dogs are regarded as man's best friend. With loyalty that is undying and eyes that you can never say no to, these guys are nothing short of adorable and lovable. Unfortunately, as wonderful as these creatures are, they are usually prone to several conditions that could be threatening their lives, and you would not even know. In today's video, we are breaking down 10 of the most common conditions and issues that could silently be affecting your dog's health and killing them gradually. Let's get into today's video. Number 1. Heartworms. Heartworm is a disease caused by parasitic worms. These worms can lead to a plethora of other diseases, from lung disease to other organ damages and even heart failure. The worms get into the body via mosquito bites. With the infection spreading in the body of the animal, the larvae from the mosquitoes start growing inside the animal's heart. From this point, the infections can move into the lungs and blood vessels. While the spreading process can happen over a span of 7 months, once the worm is fully grown, it can live inside the dog for as long as 7 years. This should scare you because heartworms can grow up to 12 inches in length, but it does not stop there. These worms can mate with each other and spread their own larvae around the body of the dog. A dog could be housing a total of 250 of these worms living inside of them at a time. While this might sound like a death sentence, if you get your dog the right treatment early enough, death is easily avoidable. So, how can you tell that your dog might be having heartworms? If you begin to notice a change in the sound of your dog's breathing, like they're facing some form of difficulty, then you should get them immediate medical attention. Another symptom to take note of is a rough and persistent cough. Also, if you find your dog being overly exhausted after mild activity, this could also be pointing to something wrong in the dog's heart. Heartworms can be medically detected by blood tests, and once detected, there are numerous products to combat the worms. However, it is important that they are prescribed by a licensed vet, which introduces our next point. Number 2. Irregular checkups. As funny as it might sound, animals also need regular visits to their doctor, like humans. For a very healthy dog, the recommended number of visits is 1 a year for the annual physical exam. The first full medical exam for your pup, however, should come immediately after you get them. The examination should cover everything health-related and ensure that they are parasite-free. As the dogs get older, each yearly checkup will concentrate on a specific area of the dog's life. In the senior years of your dog, which is just about when they turn 7, vets recommend the checkups go up to 2 times in a year. It makes sense considering that they are at a higher risk of different health problems at this age. So, the earlier the vets can discover these health issues, the easier they are to treat. It's important that you observe all of your dog's behavioral changes. Some of these changes could be signs of a lurking health problem. Number 3. Under-exercising. For people who are not the most active bunch, this one might sound a little scary. But you don't really need to be scared about this. For exercise, you do not necessarily have to take your dog out to a doggy gym every day when you can barely get yourself to do the same. Sometimes, all they really need is to be out on short walks every day and they'll be just fine. Keeping dogs indoors for too long could cause them to have too much energy packing up on the inside. Dogs always need an opportunity to export all of that energy, and if they're not getting it, they end up becoming destructive agents to your property. Additionally, little puppies might not need too much exercise since too much intensity could stress them. Regardless, as the dogs get older and older, they start needing more exercise. Like with feeding, you need to observe your dog properly to decide just how much physical activity would be good for them. Nonetheless, always ensure that your dog is burning out enough fat. Research has shown that overweight dogs live about 2.5 years less than the average healthy canine. Number 4. Lacking vaccinations. Just like humans, young pups need different vaccines. This is during the first few months of their lives. Leaving them without the necessary vaccinations they need, these pups are exposed to different levels of diseases and viruses. Apart from the heartworms we mentioned earlier in the video, the dogs also need to be protected from illnesses like canine hepatitis. This one is more of a viral infection, and it also damages various organs. It also goes for the respiratory system and the gastrointestinal tract of the dog. It is worse this time because it is contagious. Then there is kennel cough. This infection happens due to an inflammation in the dog's upper airways. As deadly as all of these sound, with the right and consistent vaccines, your dog can avoid all of them. Number 5. Bad or no dental care. This does not really need too much talk put into it. It's pretty simple. Just ensure that your dog's teeth are always clean. Action steps would include brushing their teeth regularly. It might sound a little weird, but if you're going to be a responsible dog parent, then it is something you are going to have to get used to doing. For this one, it's not completely necessary to brush their teeth every day. However, you should know that dogs with cleaner teeth tend to be healthier. Careful and regular brushing of the teeth keeps your doggies safe from gum disease, bad breath, tooth loss, and toothache. If you cannot find the time to always brush your dog's teeth, there are some other options that could work. For example, you can use teeth wipes. These are rubbed against the dog's teeth to remove plaque. You can also consider dental treats that contain ingredients that are very healthy for your pup's teeth and also keep their breath smelling fresh. Number 6. No flea, tick, or worm treatment. Do you ever notice your dog's randomly itching more than usual? If you do, the last thing you want to do is ignore them. Most importantly, you have to make an effort to keep your dog safe from fleas and ticks. While it might not be a problem in the cold weather, be sure to visit your vet for specific instructions on how to protect your dog from tick and fleas when the weather starts getting warmer. Profuse itching could cause scratch injuries that will continue to get worse the more they scratch. Injuries left open and unchecked could get infected and then lead to even worse complications. Number 7. Exposure to strong smells. If you've ever been stuck in a closed room with someone spraying a strong cologne, then you should understand this one to an extent. For humans, this chokes us so much that we can hardly breathe, and at some point we even become nauseous. With that in mind, think about dogs with more than 10,000 times more nasal abilities. If you decide to keep your dog in such a situation with strong perfumes or other strong-smelling chemicals, you're endangering the life of your dog. They have very sensitive perceiving abilities. Therefore, exposing them to strong smells exposes them to a lot of breathing-related problems and even nausea. Number 8. Bad diet. While this might sound like an obvious thing, it's still one of the main causes of premature deaths in dogs. Therefore, it is worth mentioning. Raising a dog on an improper diet can lead to several health conditions that range from mild to severe enough to kill the dog. There are a plethora of unsafe and low-quality dog foods flooding the market that you should never feed your pet. It's also important to note that there is no particularly feeding schedule for any dog. The feeding system of your dogs, that is, how often and how much they eat, is dependent on different factors. However, vets would usually recommend that a dog is fed at least 2 times a day. For dogs that develop some special conditions, they may need a special feeding schedule based on whatever they're handling. For example, if your dog is a larger breed, then automatically it would need more feeding than usual and foods with higher calories. Another factor for the feeding system would be the age of the dog. This one applies more to puppies that are growing at a very rapid rate. These guys are burning a lot of energy, so they also need to be fed as frequently as possible. In the first few months, they should be fed tiny meals. Then by the time they hit 4 months of age, they would need 3 feedings every day. Don't be scared, you'll not have to spend your life savings on dog food. In a short time, that system will drop to 2. If a dog is not fed properly, they could end up with issues like loose stools, constant itchiness, lack of concentration, and ear infections. If you're confused about how much you are to be feeding your dog at a certain stage, you can always check with your vet. Still on the topic of food, the next set of items on today's list will be directed mainly at what you should and shouldn't be feeding your pooch. Number 9. People food. No matter how cute they look with their wide eyes begging for your food, you should ignore them if you're having alcohol, avocado, macadamia nuts, grapes and raisins, and most sweets, gums, and candy. All of these contain elements that could be poisoning and killing your dog. One food that is worth special attention is chocolate. While this might not be completely harmful to humans, chocolate products contain substances known as methylxylenes. When taken in small quantities, this substance can cause the dog to fall sick and vomit uncontrollably, but large intake could lead to death. Also, do note that coffee and products containing caffeine also have similarly dangerous chemicals. Number 10, medication. First off, you should always avoid all forms of over-the-counter medication for your dogs. Whenever you notice a change in your dog's behavior or some symptoms, take them straight to the vet, because different dogs tend to have unique conditions. Medications that contain Tylenol, ibuprofen, and naproxen are poisonous to dogs. Most times, the results of these drugs are never noticed until it gets too late. You should also avoid using prescriptions meant for humans on your dog. From blood pressure medications to antidepressants and anti-inflammatory medications, these drugs could cause ulcers, kidney failure, increased blood pressure, and seizures. Well guys, that brings us to the end of this video. We hope you learned enough to help you keep your dogs healthy to live longer. Comment down below your thoughts, give this a like, share with your friends, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button and notification bell to keep you updated for more interesting facts, tips, and ideas from Smartville.